Hi everybody, welcome back to Code to Start with Mohammed Fathi. This is our YouTube channel. You can go to the playlists. You will see all our videos here into two colors. The blue one is in English and the orange one is in Arabic. Please don't forget to click on the like button, leave a comment and share my video. Today I'm gonna use the inherited widget to make the shopping cart. So I'm gonna make this app. So it will be show a lot of products here. When you select the any item or any product, it will be added to the this cart. For example, when I choose the product, for example, product 4, now the I have one product in the shopping cart. Let me select another one. So now I have 2. Let me choose another one. So it will be 3 items here. When I deselect this, it now it contains 2 items. When I click on this icon, I'm gonna go to the shopping cart or the item details. So here I have two selected item. Let me start by opening the VS Code. First, I'm gonna make the main method. So main method, first let me import the material. So material.dart. After that, I'm gonna use the main method. So main method, here I'm gonna return the call the run app method. Inside the run app method, I'm gonna call the my app. So my app widget. So I'm gonna create this widget here. It will be a stateless widget. Called my app. So here I'm gonna return material app widget, material app widget. So inside the material app, the home will be an instance of the home widget. Let me create this widget. I'm gonna create this widget by make another file here. You can make a pages here. I'm gonna make a file called home.dart. So inside this, I'm gonna import the material .dart. After that, I'm gonna, you can make a stateful widget or a stateful builder. Here I'm gonna use a stateful builder to avoid the boilerplate of two classes. So here I'm gonna make a stateless widget called, for example, called home. Here I'm gonna return the stateful builder. So stateful builder. So inside the stateful builder, I'm gonna provide the builder. The builder will be anonymous function that will take a context and another function called state setter. I'm gonna name this set state. So this will return a scaffold. So inside the scaffold, I'm gonna provide the upper. The upper will be upper widget. So here I'm gonna provide the title. The title will be a text here, shopping cart. And after that, I'm gonna provide the body. So the body now will be null. So it will be a list view. So let me make another file. This file, let me import first this main. So I'm gonna import this and try to go to the bubspec.yaml because I will start. So here I'm gonna use the badges. So if you go here and search for the Flutter or open the bub.dev, search for badges. So I'm gonna open this. So I'm gonna use this in our design. So let me copy this, or you can type badges. It's not difficult to type here. You can go here and enter and type badges and dot. So try to get this. So if you leave this here, you can. If you leave this without the version, it will be get the latest version. So when you try to get, so after that I am gonna continue. I will run the app by press the F5. When press the app will start running. So let me go to the home and. Here I'm gonna create the file for the product. Let me go here and make another file called the product.dart. The class product will contain the string name and int. For example, let me make it int price. You can make it double num price, and the is boolean. Bool is checked. So let me go to the home. Here I'm gonna create or generate a dummy list. Click over here and make list. This list will be list of product called. I'm gonna make this items. It will be list dot generate. I'm gonna generate for example 100 item, and when for each one I'm gonna execute this function. This function, so inside this function it will take the number of the item or the index. Here I'm gonna return a new product. So let me go to the product and add the constructor. So here the constructor will take the name, this dot name, this dot name, and this dot price, this dot is checked. So let me go here to the home and start here, return new product. For each product, the name will be the product. I'm gonna product concat the I, the number, and the price. It will be, for example, I can make, for example, random dot random. So I'm here, it will be import the math. So random dot next int. The maximum number will be 5,000. And after that is checked, it will be the default will be false. So this is now I have a list of items. Let me make a list view here. You can make a list view. Let me go to the here. I'm gonna make a list view. List view dot builder. So here the item. Let me first provide the item count. Item count, it will be items dot length, and the item builder. Here I am gonna execute another function. This anonymous function will take the context and the integer I or the number of the trait. So here the number of loop, I am gonna return for each item. I am gonna return list tile. So inside the list tile, the first let me make a comma semicolon here, and inside the list title tile, the list tile, first let me provide the title. The title will be row. So to make a check, so here first let me inside this I am gonna provide the children. The first one will be text. Let me wrap this with expanded. So first expanded, it will be, the child will be text. Here I'm gonna print the item. Items of I, the number dot, the name of the product. So it will be a string. After that, I'm gonna use the checkbox after this expanded. Here, this is the first one. Let me add another checkbox. Check box. Here, the checkbox, I'm gonna provide the value. So the value will be the items of I dot is checked. So this is the value. Let me try to save now. I'm gonna, so this is the items, shopping cart, and here I have a lot of items. So let me minimize this. And get the emulator here. So see, now I have a lot of items. So products, when you select, nothing happened. So let me go to here and click the unchecked, add the unchecked. Can this and make this a little smaller. Okay. Now let me add change it. I'm gonna provide this anonymous function that will take the value, the boolean value. Here I'm gonna call the set state. So inside the set state, I'm gonna execute this function, this anonymous function. Inside this, I'm gonna make the item, items of I dot is checked. I'm gonna equal to true. So what happened when you select this? So if you try to save now and click any, for example, product 3, it will be selected, and the product 4 selected. When you try to deselect, it will not work. So let me to make this work, I'm gonna negate this by equal and make this copy this and negate this by make the not here, and the it will be not equal this. So try to save now. When you select the product 4, it will be selected. Deselect it, it will work fine. So the list view now is working. So also I'm gonna add after this. Let me, this is for the tile, so the end of the tile here. Okay, this tile. So I'm gonna add the subtitle. So the subtitle will be a text here with the dollar sign. For example, here I'm gonna use the items, make this items of I dot price in the EGB, Egyptian pound. So let me try to save. Now the price will be show here. So this is work fine. Let me make wrap this with the card. So here I'm gonna wrap the list style by click on this and click on the wrap this with a widget. This widget called card. Try to save. So let me add a little of margin by providing the margin here. My margin would be edge insets dot, for example, all. I'm gonna provide 10 pixels, so it will work fine. So this is good. So let me add here on the checked. So on this checked, I will later add the unchecked here. So let me implement the add the badge here. So I'm gonna go to the home. this inside the app bar. So inside the scaffold app bar, I'm gonna provide the actions. The inside the actions here, I'm gonna use the a container. Let me add a container here. Inside the container, I'm gonna provide the margin. So margin will be edge dot only from the top. I'm gonna add, for example, 15, and in the right will be, for example, 25. And the child will be the badge. So here the badge. So the badge, inside the badge will be here. The badge will be first the badge content. Badge content, this will be a text. So for example, it will be 5. After that, I am gonna provide the icon. The child will be icon, but here the icon, here I am gonna use icons dot shopping cart, and the onPressed, it will be anonymous function. So let me save this. So now the cart will show here the number 5. It will be a change when I implementing the inherited widget. So you can make another, when you click this, I'm gonna open the another screen. So let me add another one called, for example, cart details dot dart. Here it will be, let me make import the stateless widget. First import the material, import the material. After that, I'm gonna make the stateless widget called the cart details. So here I'm gonna return scaffold. Scaffold will be a bar. With a bar widget, with the title will be text. Here cart details, and the body will be a center widget. Inside the center widget, the child will be text, and here you, and for example, can make number five selected here. It will be fixed now, and I'm gonna make the style, it will be text. I'm gonna use the theme dot of context dot text theme dot display, for example, one. Let me save to auto formatted. So it will looks like this. When you click this, I'm gonna open the this screen. So let me go to the home, and when you click on the onPressed this, I'm gonna use the navigator dot push dot, for example, of context dot push. I'm gonna use here a material page route. Material page route. The builder, let me make enter here and enter here. The builder will be anonymous function that will take a context and return the page called the cart details. Try to save now. So when you click on this, it will be open the cart details with the five selected. In the next lecture, I am gonna implement the inherited widget to make this working with sharing the state of this shopping cart, sharing the state between all the